Hello. I wasn't expecting you. You know, I was just laying in bed looking at my framed photo of Justin I keep on my nightstand. When Justin asked me to be his best man, I thought to myself, do I really know who this person is? And it was then that I decided that in the coming days and months ahead, I would search across rivers and ranges just to find out who really is Justin Stofferahn.
Disclaimer, almost all of this documentary is entirely untrue. My journey began at the office of State Representative John Bradley, where Justin worked for 2 years.
You had the pleasure of having Justin Stofferahn as an intern, is this correct?
Yeah, I finally got to meet him 6 months after he had been on the job. You know, particularly when he started, he had a great amount of absenteeism. And at the time, I didn't realize he was an alcoholic. You know, it got so bad to a point that the internship office would call us, and they were kind of monitoring Justin's progress. And Ms. Morris called from the office one time and asked me how Justin was doing. And to be honest with you, I had no idea who she was talking about. You know, I've heard the name Justin before, but the Stofferahn just totally threw me off. And then I realized after a while, she said, oh, you know, the tall, slim guy looks like John Kerry. And I said, oh, yeah, and immediately I knew who she was talking about.
So would he come to the office drinking in a rage and a rampage? You know,
yeah.
Is this kind of who Justin Stofferahn is?
Well, you know... I didn't mind him yelling at me, you know, and we didn't have any physical confrontations to a point, but I was just kind of concerned about how, you know, how hateful he was with constituents, you know, and people would call on issues and things like that. Well, many times he would, you know, tell them, hey, buddy, you need to go get a life, you know, don't expect me to solve all your problems when you created them all.
I couldn't believe what I was hearing. Alcoholism, violent outbursts, these are clear symptoms of someone desperately seeking political power. These next interviews would take me deep into the heart of Justin's character. I could only hope I was ready.
Well, I remember that he had approached me looking to run for city council in Carbondale, and this would kind of be the first step in his path to the White House. He actually had a little booklet made up. I can't even remember what year he was planning on being in the presidency, but it was on there. It was a step-by-step of how every year that he could run for office he would, and it would just move forward till he was in his regime had taken over the United States system.
So you're saying, as of this moment, everything that Justin does is a very decisive maneuver towards the presidency?
Oh, this marriage?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, purely political.
Political.
Yeah, Marissa tested very well with the voters initially, and so did the dog. You know, the whole rescue story really tugs on people's heartstrings. So, you know, that was the plan. Well, we started, everything he does is geared towards what comes next. He's in the game of chess that is life, he's about 50 moves ahead of everybody. It's actually quite frightening.
Well, he rules his campaigns with an iron fist. He is a kind of tyrant, really. As somebody who's worked on a lot of campaigns, it was by far the scariest, most difficult atmosphere that I've ever been in. Most candidates make you refer to them, as a staffer, they make you refer to them as either Mr. So-and-so or by their first names if you're closer. But Justin was always insistent that we call him the Czar. And if we failed to call him the Czar, oftentimes he would inflict some physical violence on the staff.
Wow.
So it was the week before election, and you finally made it out to one of the city council meetings for the first time and got to see what, should he be elected, he would be doing. So afterwards, he called us all aside and he said, "Do you really expect me every other Tuesday to sit at a table with all these clowns? I'm from Chicago." Then he took another pause and he said, "I'm from Chicago.
I'm from Chicago.
I'm from Chicago."
The deeper I delved, the darker things got. I wondered to myself, what would it be like to square up against a foe like Justin? It took me weeks and much convincing, but I tracked down one of his former opponents. He asked not to be identified.
Hi, I'm a former candidate against Justin Stofferahn. I ran in the 2009 city council race. From the moment I was on the ballot, I was under a constant assault. Ads were run against me 24 hours a day. People were throwing things at my house. My family couldn't leave our home for days at a time. My children couldn't go to school. It was just brutal. It was the worst thing I've ever experienced in my entire life. I remember once at a debate, Justin came up to me beforehand and whispered that if I said one negative thing about him, he would wipe me off the face of the earth. He said that he doesn't care where I went, he'd follow me, and it would be the end of my existence.
Words couldn't describe how I was feeling, but I knew I had to dig deeper. There was only one person left to talk to. My next interview would take me to the highest echelons of power. I found myself sitting with the Lieutenant Governor of Illinois.
First, can I have you introduce yourself?
Hi, my name is Sheila Simon. I am Lieutenant Governor of the state of Illinois, and more importantly, Justin's boss.
Justin's boss. No, yes. Just Justin Stofferahn. I've been going around person to person, just trying to figure out who exactly is this Justin Stofferahn. So I was wondering if you could tell me a little bit about him in particular. You know, I've heard a little bit about his political ambitions. Would you care to comment?
Absolutely. I've known Justin both on the political side and the governmental side, spending 9 months on the road with him in his small and badly working car. I realized his tremendous political skills. That's why I decided to hire him to work for me as Lieutenant Governor, so that he wouldn't be tempted to run against me for the next office that we might seek.
So Justin, kind of brute Chicago-style crony politician, would you say that kind of characterizes his political ideas and his...
Well, let's just say that while driving, he can thread the needle through speeding cars coming in the other direction and parked cars on one direction in a way that makes other people gasp. I think his political skills are no less impressive.
Could this really be the Justin I've known for 5 years? A radical, self-interested, binge-drinking sociopath? It couldn't be. The Justin I know loves everyone, has a heart larger than an ocean. So I went back and I begged these people just to tell the truth.
To be honest with you, Justin is one of the finest young men that we've ever had work in our office. J- Justin's a very dedicated individual. I think he's focused, and I expect that he will go far. He really enjoys being with people and helping people, and he's got what it takes.
I absolutely love Justin, and think the world of him. I have been honored to have him as campaign worker, as a staffer, who has played multiple roles and excelled in each one.
Justin is a phenomenal individual. Have known him for nearly 6 or 7 years, and I can definitely say that he's one of my best friends, and he's nearly family to me. That's how strong I feel about him, and I feel that he's a remarkable person, capable of remarkable things, and I'm certain that he'll succeed in whatever it is that he tries to do.
Justin's one of the best friends I've ever had. He's one of the funniest, kindest, smartest people I know. Him and Marissa have a very bright future ahead of them, and I wish them all the best.
I would like to offer a toast to Justin and Marissa. Wish you a long and happy marriage, and the best to you.
A toast to you, Justin and Marissa.
A toast to you, Justin and Marissa.
A toast to Justin and Marissa.
A toast to Justin and Marissa. I forgive you.
Justin, Marissa, I love you both. Justin, we go a long ways back, man. So long that I actually start to notice a trend. You know, it was you who was the president of the College Democrats before I was. It was you who interned for Representative John Bradley before I did. It was you who worked for Lieutenant Governor Sheila Simon before I came on board. You've been a big influence on me, man. You really have. But if I could follow your footsteps in just one more way, it would be to have a bride just like yours. Marissa, you're a wonderful person. Funny, passionate, committed. Together, both of you make a great team, and I'm so proud to be a part of your wedding. And so I'd like to raise my glass and ask the rest of you to do the same for Justin and Marissa Stofferahn. Congratulations, guys.